Hi, and welcome to this video on measurement conversions. Converting between different measurements happens all the time, whether you're measuring solutions in a chemistry lab or putting together a recipe in your kitchen. For example, let's say you're baking chocolate chip cookies and you only have measuring cups that measure in 1 cup, 1/2 cup, and 1/4 cup. But the recipe calls for 6 ounces of chocolate chips. How do you know how many chocolate chips to put in? In this video, we'll learn how to use measurement conversions to solve these sorts of problems. Let's get started. Let's start by figuring out our chocolate chip problem. Remember, we only have our cup measurements, but the recipe is asking for ounces. Well, this is where conversions come in handy. In order to figure this out, we need to set up conversion fractions. The first step in setting up conversion fractions is finding our conversion factor. A conversion factor relates one quantity to another. In our chocolate chip example, our conversion factor is 1 cup equals 8 ounces. Now that we know what our conversion factor is, we can set up our conversion fraction. When setting up these fractions, always start with your known value as your first fraction by placing it over 1, like this. 6 ounces over 1. We then multiply by our conversion factor, which we also need to turn into a fraction. When we do this, we want to pay close attention to which value we place in the numerator and which value we place in the denominator. Since we have ounces and we are looking for cups, we want to place our cup value in the numerator and our ounces value in the denominator, so that our ounces units will cancel out and we will be left with cups. There's 1 cup, has 8 ounces. We then multiply across and simplify. So our ounces cancel out, and we're left with 6 times 1 cup is 6 cups over 8. So there are 6/8 of a cup, or 3/4 cups is equal to 8 ounces. Notice how our ounces cancel out on top and bottom, and we're able to simplify the fraction 6/8 by dividing both parts by 2. This gives us our final answer of 6 ounces equals 3/4 cups. So we need 3/4 of a cup of chocolate chips for our cookie recipe, and can use our 1/4 cup measuring cup 3 times. Let's look at another example. Sarah is driving down a road at 30 miles per hour. How fast is she traveling in feet per second? This problem is a little different from our last one because it will require 2 conversions. We need to find our conversion factors for miles to feet and for hours to minutes. There are 5,280 feet in a mile and 3,600 seconds in an hour. So our conversion factors are 1 mile equals 5,280 feet and 1 hour equals 3,600 seconds. First, we write our known value as a fraction. Notice that this is in miles per hour, so we are going to write the miles part on top and the hour part on bottom. She travels 30 miles in 1 hour, so we'll write it like this. Now we want to multiply by our conversion factors. Remember, we have 2 different conversion factors, so we need to be sure to include both in this step. There are 5,280 feet in 1 mile. And we want to put the mile on bottom because we want our units to cancel out. And in 1 hour, there are 3,600 seconds. Again, we have our hour on top over here because we have it on bottom over here and we want them to cancel out. So when we multiply through, our hours cancel out, our miles cancel out, and then we can just multiply across. So we have 30 times 5,280 feet over 3,600 seconds. When we simplify, this gives us 44 feet per second. If Sarah is traveling 30 miles per hour, she is also traveling 44 feet per second. Let's take a look at one more example. Caleb is painting a wall that is a total of 96 square feet. How big is the room in square inches? In this example, we need to pay close attention to our units. We are measuring in square feet, which means our conversion fractions will look a little different. Our conversion factor for feet to inches is 1 foot equals 12 inches. However, if you think ahead, we are going to run into a problem in our second step. Let's go through our process as normal and see if we can figure out what to do once we get there. We start by writing out our known value. 96 square feet. Remember, we used conversion fraction, so we want to turn this into a fraction, so we divide by 1. Then we multiply by our conversion factor. There are 12 inches in 1 foot. Remember, feet needs to be diagonal to each other so that eventually they'll cancel out. But what's wrong with this conversion? Well, if you multiply the units out, you can see that we'll be left with feet times inches, because one of our feet will cancel out, but the other one won't. To fix this, we simply need to multiply once more by our conversion factor. Since we are working with square units, it makes sense that we would multiply by our conversion factor twice, or in other words, multiply by our conversion factor squared. Let's finish out our problem by multiplying it all out. Our feet squared will cancel out with both of our feet down here. So we're left with 96 times 12 times 12 square inches. When we multiply this out, we'll get an answer that is equal to 13,824 square inches. And that's all there is to it. This process will work for conversions between any two units. As long as you know your conversion factors, you can follow these steps and find your new measurement. I hope this review is helpful. Thanks for watching and happy studying.